Now let's begin with a new topic, that is estimating the products. The calculation is similar to subtraction and addition, which we have done in the last video, but there are few more new things which I'll be telling you in this video. So kindly pay attention and listen to the instructions very carefully. Suppose this is my first case, okay, 53 into 18, and we have to round off both the numbers nearest to 10. So again, as I have told you in my previous video, we will follow the same method. We'll do what? We will take the numbers individually and round them off to nearest 10. We know 5 and 1. Both the digits belong to tens place. So what we will do, we will look at the digit which is on the right hand side. So 3 and 8. We are going to look at these two digits. Now we know 3 is less than 5. So what will happen? It will become 0. 3 is less than 5, so it will become 0 and the number will be 15. And we know 18, 8 is bigger than 5. So what will happen? This 8 will give plus 1 to this and itself will become 0. So we'll write 0 here and 1 plus 1 will give you 20. Okay, so these are the two new numbers which are formed after rounding off. And we have to take out what? We have to take out the product. Product means what? Multiplication. So let's write these two numbers and let's take out the product. Now here you do not have to go into detail and do the calculation. Just do direct multiplication as I have told you in class 5th also. Count the number of zeros in both the numbers. Zeros which are at the end of the number, not in between. So there are how many zeros? One here and one here. So in the answer, write 00 first. Zero calculation is over. Now what is left? 5 into 2 or 2 into 5. We know 5 into 2 is how much? 10. So this is your answer. Now this is a second case. Okay, here two numbers are given. 678 and 215. We have to take out the product and they have to be rounded off to nearest 100. So let's write the numbers separately. And let's first round them off to nearest 100 place value. We know this and this is the 100 place value. So we are going to look at the digit which is on the right hand side. 7 and 1. Now this 7 is bigger than 5, greater than 5, and this 1 is less than 5. So what we will do, this 7 will give plus 1 here and this 1 will become 0 here. Rules are given in my last video. You can check the last video also. 678. Now this 7 is bigger than 5. So what will it do? It will give plus 1 to this digit which is mentioned on the place value. So 6 will get plus 1 and it will become 7. And this will remain, this will become 0 and this will also become 0. So the first required number is 700. Now 215. This 215, this one right hand side digit, is already smaller than 5. So what will happen? It will become 0, the other digit will become 0 and 2 will remain the same. Remember, when it is less than 5, it itself becomes 0 and all other digits which start from that limit to the right hand side will become 000, and before ones will remain the same. So now we have got the two numbers. The first number is 700 and the next number is 200. So we are going to do direct multiplication here. Count the number of zeros at the end of both the numbers. 2 are here and 2 are here. So 2 plus 2 will give you 4. So 4 zeros first we will put in the answer. And we know 7 into 2. Now we have to multiply 7 into 2. 7 into 2 will be what? 14. So this is your answer. Okay. So now let's begin with the third case of this rounding off portion. Now here there is a new thing which we are learning now. That is round off the first number upwards and second number downwards. Now what are these two things? Upwards and downwards. Here I will explain you with a simple example. Try to understand first. The number is 2, 6, 7. They are asking us to round off the first number upwards and second number downwards. So this is the first number and this is the second number. So this has to be rounded off upwards and this is downward. This has to be done what? Downwards. Now 267. Now we will see the limit. Okay, so the first case is 267. So what we will do, the easy trick of doing this is what? See the limit between which this number is coming. This number is coming between the limit 200 and 300. It comes in between. And they're asking us to round off this number upwards. So instead of taking this 200, we will take it what? 300. So 267 when rounded upwards will become what? 300. Is it clear? Now many must be thinking that why ma'am has taken this, why ma'am has rounded off this number to 300, not to 200. Remember, this is the lower limit and this is the upper limit. And obviously when they are asking us to round off upwards, we will go with this limit, not with this limit. We are going to take up this limit, not with this, not this limit. Now let's take the second number, 146. 146. Okay, we have to round off downwards. It has to be downwards. So let's see the limit between which this number is coming. It is coming between 100, 200. So here we have written the limit between which this number will come. And they are asking us to round off this number downwards. We know this is the lower limit and this is the upper limit. When they are asking us to round off downwards, we are obviously going to choose lower limit, not the upper limit. So 146 answer will be what? 100. This is how we round off the upper and the downwards whenever they are given in the question. Now in both the cases we have done the calculation. 267 is rounded off upwards and the answer is coming 300, and this is rounded off downwards and the answer is coming 100. So now let's just multiply and get the, take out the answer, 200. Okay, let's do direct multiplication. We know how many zeros are coming. We can see here very clearly two zeros here and two zeros here. So directly in the answer we are going to write four zeros first, and 3 into 1 will give you 3. So this is your answer. Now let's take the second case, that is 680 into 164. The first number has to be rounded off upwards and this has to be rounded down downwards. We know 680 comes between the limit of 600 and 700. And we know this is lower limit and this is the upper limit. And 680 has to be rounded off upwards. So we will go with the 700 limit. So 680, when rounded off upwards, the answer will be 700. Now let's take the this number, 164. We know 164 comes between the limit of 100 and 200. And they're asking us to round off downwards. And we know this is the down limit, or you can say this is the lower limit and this is the upper limit. So when they're asking us to round off downwards, we are going to obviously choose this 100 limit. So 164, when rounded off downwards, will become what? 100. So now we have got two numbers, that are 700 and 100 here. These are the two numbers. So let's simply multiply them, 700 into 100. We will do direct multiplication here, 0, 0 and 0, 0. So at the end of the numbers, both the numbers, we'll count how many zeros are coming. Here 2 zeros and here 2 zeros. So 2 plus 2 will give you 4. So 4 zeros you'll put in the answer, and we know 7 into 1 will give you 7. So this is the answer. Now this is the third case. 255 has to be rounded off upwards and this has to be rounded off downwards. We know 255 comes between the limit of what? 200 to 300. It has to be rounded off what? Upwards. So we will go with this upper limit. So 255, when rounded off upwards, the answer will come 300. Now let's take 350. Now this has to be rounded off downwards. We know 350 comes between 300 and 400 limit. This is the down limit, or you can say the lower limit. And this is the upper limit. So when you round off 350, so when you round off 350 to lower limit or downwards, the number will be 300. So 350, answer will be 300. Now you have got two. This 255 is also giving you what? 300. Because 255 is coming between 200 and 300. And upper limit is what? 300. So this is rounded off to upwards. So answer is coming 300. Now this 350 lower limit is also is 300. So here the answer again is what? 300. Coincidentally, both the answers are coming 300. So let's simply multiply now 300 into 300. Zeros and zeros. How many zeros are there? Total 4 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 3 into 3, 9. Till now, what we were doing, we were rounding off the first number upwards and second number downwards. Now, there is a different case, reverse of whatever we were doing till now. Now, the first number has to be rounded out downwards and the second number upwards. Let's take a certain case. So the case is what? 356 multiplied by 278. This is the first case of such kind. We know 356 is coming between 300 to 400. This is the lower limit and this is the upper limit. When you round off 356 downwards, you will obviously choose 300. So 356, when rounded off downwards, answer will be what? 300. Now the next number is what? 278. Now we know this 278 comes between 200 and 300 limit. This is the lower limit and this is the upper limit. Now the second number, this is the second number, this has to be rounded off upwards. So we are going to take this upper limit. So again, 278 when rounded off upwards will give you the answer 300. So this is the first number, this is the second number. So 300 into 300 will give you what? 0000. So how many zeros will come in the answer? 4 zeros. And 3 into 3 will give you 9. So this is your answer. Now the second case is what? 578 has to be rounded off downwards and 369 has to be rounded off upwards. So now what we will do? We will do the treatment separately. First we will take this number 578. Okay, and we know this 578 comes between 500 to 600. Again, upper limit and lower limit. So 578 has to be rounded off downwards. So we are going to take this limit. So 578, when rounded off downwards, answer will be what? 500. Now the second case is what? 369. The second number has to be rounded off upwards. We know 369 comes between what? 300 to 400 limit. It has to be rounded off upwards. So we are obviously going to choose this upper limit. So 369, when rounded off upwards, will give you the answer 400. So these are the two new numbers which are found. So let's simply multiply them. 500 into 400. Let's count the number of 0. 2 zeros here and 2 zeros here will give you how many zeros? 4 zeros. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And 5 into 4 or 4 into 5 is what? 20. So this is your answer. Now let's begin with the new topic, that is estimating the quotients. Now this topic is in context with exercise to exercise, that is 1F. Till now we have done two kinds of rounding off. That was very simple. First one was nearest to 10, 100, 1000. And second one was rounding off upwards and downwards. Now this third case is a new case when nothing is mentioned. When nothing is mentioned till where you will round off, whether you will round off upwards or downwards, then what will be the, how you will do the rounding off. Now the third case is what? Nothing is mentioned. How you will round off the numbers when nothing is mentioned? Suppose a number is given in hundreds. Now this is a number which is given in hundreds. Okay, so what I will consider that I have to round off this number nearest to hundredth place value. Now I know this is the number hundredth place value and this is the digit on the right hand side. Now this is 9 more than 5. So what I will do, I will give plus 1 to this digit and the answer will become what? 800. So what I have done in this case, here the number was given in 100. So I have considered that I have to round off this number nearest to hundredths place. Let's take another case. Now the number is 3, 2, 4. Now this number is again given in hundredths. Okay, so what I will consider that I have to round off till hundredths place value. Now this is belongs to 100 place. 2 is the digit on the right hand side. So what I will do, this 2 is less than 5. So it will give me what? 300. So this is what you do when nothing is mentioned. Now let's take a number in tens. Suppose 84 is given. So what I will consider here that I have to round off this number nearest to this place. So I'm going to look at this digit which is on the right hand side. This is 4 less than 5. So it will give me the number 18. Again, let's take another case. That is 44 or 48. 48 is the next case. Now this number, nothing is given whether I have to round it off upwards or downwards or nearest to 100 place or tens place, whatever, nothing is given. But this number, I can see it is two digit number. So I'll round off this number nearest to tens place. I know this now, this digit belongs to tens place. And 8 is the digit on the right hand side. Now 8 is more than 5. So it will give plus 1. It will give plus 1 to this digit mentioned on the place value. It will become 5. And this will automatically become 0. So this is what we do when nothing is mentioned, whether we have to round off nearest 10, 100, 1000 or whatever. So this is what you have to do in exercise 1F. And when numbers are obtained, when numbers are formed, new numbers are formed, you can see here, new numbers are formed, then you have to divide these numbers and you get your answer. Then the answer is again rounded off, which I will be telling you further. Now we have given done what? If the number is given in hundreds, if the number is given in tens, suppose if the number is given in thousands, a number is there that is 3500. This is a number and nothing is given whether I have to round it off to which place? Tens place, hundred place. So what I will consider here that I have to round off this number nearest to 1000. This is given in 1000, the number is in 1000 and I will round off to 1000 place only. Now this 3 number belongs to which place? 1000. So I am going to look at the digit which is on the right hand side. Now this is 5. The rule is what? It should be 5 or greater than 5. It should be greater than 5. 7, it can be 6, 7, 8 or 9. 5, it will give plus 1. To the digit mentioned on the place value and it will become 1400. So here why I have taken such examples to show you, if nothing is mentioned then you round off the numbers to nearest the places in whichever form that number is given. Suppose the number is given in hundreds, so you will round off to 100 place. If the number is given in tens, then round off to nearest 10. If a number is given in thousands, then round off to 1000. This is what you do when no information is given, when no instructions are given, whether you have to round off upwards or downwards. So what we do, if the numbers are given in hundreds, we round off them to 100. If it's given in tens, 2-digit, 3-digit or 4-digit, then we do it accordingly. Now let's take few examples of estimating the questions. Let the first example be 87 divided by 28. Now both these numbers are given in tens, that is 2-digit and 2-digit. So what I'll do, I'll round them off nearest to tens place. So I'm going to look at the digit which is on the right hand side. Now 7 and 8, both are greater than 5. So what will it do? It will give plus 1 here and it will become what? 19. Because this automatically becomes what? 0. Now this is 28. This will give plus 1 here and itself will become 0. So this will become what? 30. So now the two numbers formed are what? 90 divided by 30. We will do direct division. 90 divided by 30. 0 cancelled. 4 zeros are cancelled. And 3 ones are and 3. 3 is equal to 3. Okay. So this is what? Direct division. Now let's take another example. Suppose now the question is 74 divided by 34. 74 when rounded off nearest to tens place will give you 70, and 34 when rounded off nearest to tens place will give you 30. Let's divide these two numbers. On division, answer will be 7 upon 3. When we will divide, we will get the answer 2.33. Now this is a new thing here. You got the answer for 2.33, but we have to give the answer in whole number. So we have to round it off. Okay, we have to round this number off. So what we will do, we will see the digit which is coming just after the decimal point. We will see the digit which is coming just after the decimal point. Now this digit is 3. We will apply the same rules which we have applied before. Now this 3, this digit is less than what? 5. So it will become 0 and this will remain the same. So the answer will be what? 2. This is called what? When the answer you get in decimal number, you round it off and you get the answer in whole numbers. Let's discuss few more cases. Suppose your answer is coming 22.4. Okay, these are certain cases which I'll be discussing here. And the answer is coming 6. These are the certain cases which suppose you are getting these numbers as the answer. Then what you will do? Now this 22.4, we have to remove this decimal number and we have to change it into whole numbers. Okay. So what we will do, you must have seen sometimes your elder brother and sister, they do not tell you the exact percentage scored by them. They do not tell you that they have got 83.27 or 90.1.5, whatever. They do not tell you in detail. They always round off the number. So this is here. This is what is here in front of you. Now 22.4. What we will do, we have to remove the decimal point. So we will look at the digit which is coming just after the decimal point. Now this digit here is what? 4. Here it is 8 and here it is 6 and here it is 2. Okay, now this 4 is less than 5. So what will happen? It will do nothing. It will become 0. And 22 will remain the same. And I told you before also 22.0 is nothing. It is 22 only. Now this number 763.8. Now this 8, we have to round off this number and we have to make it a whole number. So we have to remove this decimal point. Now after decimal point, the rule is what? You will see the digit which is coming just after the decimal point. Whether it has so many digits here, no problem. You will just see the digit which is coming just after the decimal point. So the digit here is what? 8. 8, which is more than 5. So what it will do? It will give plus 1 here. Itself will become 00. Understood? Now let's see the second case. Now after decimal point, I told you whether the decimal numbers are these many, no problem. You will just look at the digit which is all coming after the decimal point. Now after decimal point, what is the digit? 6. Okay. So what we will do? This is more than 5. So we will give plus 1 here. And will become 198. Now suppose the case is this. It is 2 less than 5. So what it will do? It will become 0. And the rest part will remain the same. Understood everyone? Now this is the case when you have to round off the decimal numbers. And you have to make them whole numbers. So you look at the digit which is coming just after the decimal point. Now let's take one more example. 694 divided by 58. Nothing is mentioned whether you have to round off till 100, tens, nothing is mentioned. But I know the 694 is a number in hundreds. So what I will do, I will round off till 100 place value. Now this 58, I know this is a number in tens. So what I will do, I will round off till nearest 10. Now this is belongs to tens value and this belongs to 100 value. So we are going to look at the digit which is on the right hand side. This is 9 more than 5 and this is 8 more than 5. Both of them will give plus 1 to the digit mentioned on the place value. 694 will give plus 1 here because this is more than 5. So the answer will be, it will become 0 and this will become 0 and this will become 7. Now 58, now this 8 is more than 5. So it will give plus 1 here to the digit mentioned on the place value. So 5 plus 1 will get become 6 and this digit becomes 0. So the, now the two new numbers formed are 700 divided by 60. Let's divide them. 700 divided by 60. 0, 0 cancelled. After cancelling 0, what is left? 70 divided by 6. Let's divide them. 70 divided by 6. It will go one time. 1 will be the remainder. 0 will come down. It will go one time. 4 will come down. We will put a point here. Decimal point and we will bring 0 down. We will put a point here and we will bring 0 down. Okay, because 4 was the only remainder. Now 40 goes how many times? We know it will go 6 times. And again we will get the same thing. So no need to divide again and again because we know answer will come what? 11.66. 11.66. But we do not have to give the answer in decimal point. We have to round off and make it a whole number. So we are just going to look at the digit which is coming after the decimal point. This is 6. It is what? More than 5. What will we do? What it will do? It will simply give plus 1 here. Okay. And itself will become 0, 0. Now this point, it itself will become 0, 0. And it will give plus 1 here. So 1 plus 1 will give, become 1, 2. And here it will be 1. So this is your answer. Now let's take one more example from the exercise. That is question number 9. 858. Divided by 39. Now again, listen carefully. Here no instructions are given whether you have to round off till tens or 100. Nothing is given, but we will understand what we will do. We will see the numbers and do the treatment accordingly. We know 858 is a number given in hundreds. So we are going to round off till 100 place value. We are going to look at the digit which is on the right hand side. It is 5. It is more than, it is 5. And what we will do, if we will give plus 1 here, and itself will become 1, the other numbers will become 0, 0. This is your number. Now 39, we are going to round off nearest till tens place because it is given in tens. We do not have any instruction here. So we will round off to nearest tens place. We are going to look at the digit which is on the right hand side. This is 9 more than 5. So it will give plus 1 to the digit mentioned on the place value. So this will become 4 and this will become 0. So now the two new numbers are 900 divided by 40. So 900 when divided by 40, let's see, 0 cancelled, 0 divided by 4. You know this will go 2 times, it will become, it will get what, 8 here, 102. So what is the answer coming? 22.5. But we don't want the answer in decimal number. We have want the answer in whole numbers. So what will I do? What we will do, we will look at the digit just after the decimal point. After the decimal point, what is given there? 5. Okay. The second rule is what? The number should be either 5 or more than 5. So yeah, it is 5. So we will give plus 1 here and itself will become 0. So 2 plus 1 will get 3. So this is your answer. Let's take one more example. 275 divided by 25. Let's round off both the numbers. 275, we will round off till 100 place value, and this till 10th place value. We are going to look at this digit, we are going to look at this digit here. Both are what? Here it is 5, 7 more than 5, here it is 5. So what we will do, it will give plus 1 here, so the number will become 300. And it will give plus 1 here, so the number will become 130. Answer is 10. So here you do not get, you haven't got the answer in decimal, you have directly got the answer in whole numbers, so no need of further calculation. Here you have already got the answer in whole number. Now here comes my last example, last discussion with you all of a question number. Suppose if I take 8 of exercise 1F, question is what? 729 divided by 29. Let's round off both our numbers. We know 729, this is a number given in 100, so we will round off nearest to 100th place value. And this is a number given in 10, so we will round off till 10th place value. We are going to look at this digit here. This is less than 5, so it will become 0. The other digits after it will become 0, and this will remain the same. Now here, this is what? 9 more than 5. So it will give plus 1 here, and itself will become what? 0. So now the two numbers, new numbers formed are what? 700 divided by 30. Both of them have to be, they have to be divided. Let's divide them. 70 divided by 3. Let's do the division. So again and again you will get 23. You will get 3 here. So we will stop here only. Now we have to give the answer in whole numbers. So we are going to look at the digit which is after the decimal point. Here it is 3, less than 5. So what it will do? It will become 0, and this will remain the same. So the answer is 23. Hope you all have understood. In case you have doubt, you can ask me in the group. And kindly solve all the sums of this exercise as well as the previous exercise. Thank you.